Course title is Multi-Hop Networks. Course code CS477. Today's is lecture number 13. Topic is Wireless Network Security. The agenda of today's lecture is listed below. First, we will discuss what is a secure network, what are the different security requirements, different types of security attacks, what is the relationship amongst different security attacks. We will discuss few passive attacks, few active attacks, and few denial of service attacks. In the last, we will discuss intrusion detection system in detail. A secure network. A secure network ensures three important parameters. Number one, users' data confidentiality, which means that nobody is allowed to understand or read the data which is being transmitted from source to destination. Only source and destination can understand or read the data. Similarly, sender and receiver identity is kept secret by a secure network. Secure network does not expose the identity of senders and receivers. Number two, data integrity, which means that nobody is allowed to make changes in the data which is being transmitted from source to destination. Number three, networks or network resources availability. A secure network ensures network resources availability, which means that network resources are always available to registered users or subscribers. Unauthorized users or attackers cannot deny network resources to legitimate users. Network security requirements. There are three important network security requirements. These are data confidentiality, data integrity, and availability. These are already discussed in our previous slide. Types of attacks. Basically, there are three types of attacks: passive attacks, active attacks, and denial of service attacks. First, we will discuss passive attacks. These are silent in nature. Passive attacks do not harm the network. These attacks are used to steal information or capture information from data under transmission from source to destination. These attacks, if successfully conducted, can take important information such as credit card information, sender and receiver location, sender and receiver identity. Active attacks. These are used to disturb the normal flow of network traffic. Active attacks are used to drop network packets, modify the data in packets, or misdirect the network traffic. Denial of service attacks. These attacks are used to deny one or more network related services. In DoS attack, legitimate users are prevented from network or network resources, which means legitimate users cannot use network or network resources. Here we will discuss the relationship of secure networks, its characteristics, and different security attacks. In this diagram, you can see, as we already discussed, a secure network ensures three important parameters, that is confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Three important type of security attacks are passive attacks, active attacks, and denial of service attacks. In this diagram, you can see passive attacks are used to target confidentiality of a network. Active attacks are used to target the integrity, while denial of service attacks are used to target availability of a network. There are many types of passive attacks. However, we will discuss only two important types of passive attacks, that is averse dropping and brute force attack. In averse dropping, the attackers can averse drop any desired wireless link easily. The averse dropper can capture and listen to the ongoing traffic of communication channel using such tools which are easily available. Averse dropping can be successfully conducted with the help of snipers. A sniper may be an application or device which is used to read and capture the network packets. The sniper applications can also be used to detect SSID and collect the MAC address of the node. This attack is less severe for the wireless network, however, more severe for the target users if sensitive information are captured, such as credit card number, social security number. To avoid averse dropping, strong encryption is the possible way to defend this kind of attack. Brute force attack. Most of the access points in the same wireless network use almost similar type of username and passwords. Once known, the attacker can get complete control of the network. Brute force attack is used to break the password of an access point by periodically testing every possible password from brute force dictionary. Access points having broadcast usernames and weak or static password can easily be compromised. If the brute force attack is used only to analyze traffic, then it is a passive attack, otherwise active. After any successful passive attack, the attacker has the desired information about the nodes and is able to conduct an active attack. Few important types of active attacks. An active attack attempts to alter system resources or affect their operations. Active attacks involve some modifications of the data stream or creation of false statements. Basically, active attacks are used to harm network traffic. Few important types of active attacks are packet dropping attacks, packet modification attacks, and packet misdirection attacks. Denial of service is a severe form of active attack in which network services are denied to legitimate users. There are many different types of denial of service attacks. Few are discussed here. Selfish router access point. In this type of attack, the attackers target the router or access point. Once the router or access point is made selfish, legitimate users are not able to use network services such as internet. Flooding attacks. In flooding attack, a single attacker flood a lot of traffic or packets toward target nodes. Target node may be an access point or gateway. The flooding of traffic overflow the resources of target nodes, such as CPU usage, memory usage, etc. Due to overflow of such resources, the target node is then not capable to entertain requests from legitimate users. Distributed flooding attacks. When many attacking nodes or attackers flood traffic towards an important target node, it is known as distributed flooding attack. It is very difficult to handle distributed denial of service attack, as such collaborative and distributed flooding attacks consumes all network resources. A legitimate users cannot access network resources at all. In this diagram, you can see three different infected nodes are flooding traffic toward the target node. The target node resources are overflow and the legitimate user is not capable to access network resources. intrusion detection systems. An intrusion is any unwanted activity either in the form of passive attacks or active attacks which are used by the attackers to create undesired situation and harmful consequences for the user's confidentiality, network integrity, or network resource availability. In simple words, any set of actions they try to compromise the data integrity, user's confidentiality, or service availability can be termed as intrusion. While a system that attempts to detect such malicious action of network or compromised nodes is called intrusion detection system. The security level of wireless networks can be enhanced up to certain limit by implementing intrusion detection system. The primary function of intrusion detection system is to monitor users' activities, network behavior at different OSI layers. A single perfect defense is not feasible in wireless networks, as there always exist some architectural weaknesses, software bugs, or design flaws which may be compromised by the intruders. The best practice to secure the wireless network is to implement multi-lines of security mechanisms. Intrusion detection systems are considered passive defense, as it is not intended to prevent attacks. Instead, it alerts network administrator about possible attack well in time to stop or reduce the impact of the attack. The accuracy of intrusion detection system is generally measured in terms of false positive and false negatives, where an ideal IDS attempts to minimize both these. Classification of intrusion detection systems. There are two important types of intrusion detection systems. Number one, pattern-based intrusion detection systems. Number two, anomaly-based intrusion detection systems. Pattern-based intrusion detection systems has the capability to identify all the known intrusions or attacks, while anomaly-based intrusion detection systems have the intelligence to identify and respond to new intrusions which are not known. IDS are further classified as standalone intrusion detection systems, distributed and collaborative intrusion detection systems, and hierarchical intrusion detection systems. Standalone intrusion detection systems operates on each node independently to determine intrusions by monitoring the internal events which are recorded in the system logs. In distributed and cooperative intrusion detection systems, every node participates in intrusion detection and response. While in hierarchical intrusion detection systems, the cluster head monitors all of its child nodes and respond in case of intrusion is detected. Intrusion detection systems components. There are three important components of intrusion detection systems. Number one, monitoring component. Number two, intrusion database. Number three, response component. Monitoring component is used for local events as well as neighbors' events monitoring. Intrusion database contains the records of recent misbehaviors as well as reputation value of the neighbor's node. Response component is used to respond in case of intrusion is detected. The response may be to raise an alarm, to alert the administrator, or to broadcast the information to its neighbor nodes about the misbehaving node.